This is how to get the heat associated with phase changes. Benzene has the following physical properties. We're given melting point, boiling point, heat of fusion, heat of vaporization, and specific heat of the liquid phase. And we're asked, calculate delta H, that's the heat change, for the conversion of 62.8 grams of solid benzene at its freezing point to benzene vapor at its boiling point. Okay. Well, let's think about the steps that are involved from taking solid benzene to vapor phase benzene. We are going to start with benzene as a solid at its melting point, which is 5.1 degrees Celsius, and convert it to benzene as a liquid at 5.1 degrees Celsius. That'd be step one. Then we need to think about, okay, now we have benzene as a liquid at 5.1 degrees Celsius, but we need to get it to its boiling point. So the benzene will still be liquid, but now at its boiling point of 80.3 degrees Celsius. That'd be the second step. Third step would be to convert our liquid to vapor. So we have benzene that is a liquid at 80.3 degrees Celsius, its boiling point, going to benzene as a vapor at 80.3 degrees Celsius. Okay. When we are doing a phase change from solid to liquid, the heat involved in this change is actually equal to the number of moles we have times the heat of fusion. So we will take our 62.8 grams of benzene. We will divide by the molar mass, which is calculated out to be 78.108 grams of benzene per one mole of benzene. And we will look up the heat of fusion, which turns out to be 11.6 kilojoules per mole of material. So multiplying all that out gives us 9.33 kilojoules. So that's step one. The next one is actually liquid to liquid, but we're changing the temperature. So now we need to use the formula Q equal MS delta T. So our mass of benzene is 62.8 grams. The specific heat of benzene is 1.26 joules per gram degrees Celsius. And our temperature change is going to be 80.3 degrees Celsius minus 5.1 degrees Celsius. So I will multiply all that out, and it turns out that I have 5,950 joules. Since I'm going to be adding the results of step 1, 2, and 3, it might be nice to convert this one to kilojoules. So how about 5.95 kilojoules of heat? Okay, the last step is another phase change. We're going from liquid to gas. So Q, or delta H, for phase change is equal to N, this time times the heat of vaporization. So I will take the same ratios I had at the start. I will start with my 62.8 grams of benzene. I will determine how many moles of benzene that is by dividing by the molar mass. And I will find the heat of vaporization. times 35.7 kilojoules per mole of material, and I will multiply that out, and it turns out that the value is 28.70 kilojoules. Okay, my last step is to take these three values, 1, 2, 3, and add them together to find out what the sum is. The sum turns out to be 43.98 kilojoules. And then finally, I should think about sig figs. Three sig figs went into all of these, so that one is good to the hundredths place, the hundredths place, and the tenths place. So technically, when I report my answer, it should be to the tenths place as 44.0 kilojoules. And that's all.